the world champion on floor, the sensational junior European champion in 1980, this girl, and has continued still, only 17 now. Time to pause between the major moves. And another magnificent performance. Mary Lou Retton, 16, born in a small town in West Virginia where she was the toughest kid on the block, boys included. Moved on to Houston, coached by Bella Caroli. Ability, Mary Lou Retton. But she really is quite sensational. American audience don't know whether to gasp or whoop. Incredibly, they bring their own originality to a routine that's been done now by more than 100 girls. Oh, superb. Quite superb. The timing at the end was perfection.
Waiting for her score from the first ball. Now a good look at this young lady who is the big star of Romania.
Very good position all the way around. She's got distance and height.
There's a 10 for Szabo's first ball.
Thank you. again count 50% of the total team score. The optionals, another 50%. And here is the woman they call the Belarusian Swan.
And John, this is the woman that has all but owned this apparatus. Watching her in the rehearsals, she pretty much won this event. So we'll be seeing what she can put together this evening. This is one of the big skills in the compulsory routine. What Boginskaya does so beautifully on this apparatus is she shows great extension, not to mention the flexibility shown right there in that back walk of her. Oop, a little break right there.
You can hear the music from the floor exercise blaring in the background there. Another competitor on Florex. I still have to maintain that that has to be distracting. Do you think it bothers her?
I think she is so focused on this event. She has competed so many times before in situations like this that she is just blocking everything else away. She's getting set for her dismount. So far, just a couple of very minor wobbles. Dismount, round off, full twist, and she knew she had to stick that landing.
This woman has won 4 Olympic medals, 6 world championship medals, and 8 European championship medals. She is tough to beat. Boginskaya's score for balance beam, a 9.875. Svetlana Boginskaya. A near perfect score for Svetlana Boginskaya. As they said on the walls of the stadium in Baltimore for the Olympic trials, it is Miller time. Here she is on the beam.
Shannon's scores are not only helping for the overall team final, but she has to be thinking down the line to the event finals. This is an apparatus that she can certainly win a gold medal on.
These performances today from a woman who dislocated her elbow this spring. She had surgery. They inserted a micro screw in her arm to repair it.
You know, interesting, I spoke with the Unified coaches. They are amazed at her recovery. They said they had an athlete with a similar injury. Took about a year.
Choreography and the beam work for Shannon was just picking apart the routine and just pulling out certain little sections, making sure that every hand movement was right on.
the judges say a 9.887 for Shannon. Here's Henrietta Anodi, the Hungarian. This is a beautiful piece of music that they use for the compulsory floor exercise, but I'll tell you, hearing it over and over and over again, I'm ready for the optionals. And they get to choose their own music.
Was a real treat to watch. You know, I'm seeing a much more relaxed Henrietta.
And you know, we've seen some real great dancers, we've seen some great tumblers. That was really the first routine that put everything together. That was wonderful.
9.937, the judges agree with you. Turned out real well. The Soviet said, get this woman into gymnastics as soon as you can. They did, and this is the results. Shannon Miller, and a good score is very important here off of that 9.35 from Zemeskal, because the way this competition works, the top five scores are taken on each piece of apparatus that can throw out the low score.
Take a look at this tumbling run. The opening, last Arabian, opens it up.
110.
Lots of height. Really a super effort here.
And you know, she was often criticized for not being very powerful, but I tell you, she looked pretty powerful today.
And the judges liked it, a 9.887. John Tesh, Elfie Schlegel, and Tim Daggett at the Palo San Jordi at the Olympic Games, watching American Shannon Miller establish herself as the woman to beat. One last piece of apparatus, it is the vault for her.
John, this is one of those up and down events for Shannon. When she's on, she's great. When she's off, can make a significant difference, and tonight she is on.
That was on.
Obviously the most important thing.
There it is.
You gotta stick that landing, and she nailed it.
Henrietta Anodi, Hungary.
This has been a strong apparatus for Henrietta. She's capable of putting up some very top scores.
And a reminder, her team is not in contention, but She is going to be a tough one to beat in the all-around competition later this week.
That's right. You need these compulsory exercises to qualify into the individual event and the all-around finals.
Very smooth routine, no major breaks. Top score coming up.
Boy, another great score for her. 9-9 for Henrietta Noddy. But the big story today is this young lady, Shannon Miller. She is in first place following the compulsories. The good news for Shannon Miller individually, first ever compulsories, her team, the U.S., second behind the five team. Shannon Miller is on the uneven bars for the Americans. Kim Zemeskal has already scored a near perfect 9.9.
She's doing well. She already hit her opening combination. This is one great bar routine. There's her second release move. She has a big dismount plan. Oh, the only one to stick her dismount thus far.
No hop there. Now compare that for me to Zemeskal, who just got a 9.9.
No question that routine was far more difficult than Zemeskal's.
Here's the dismount, Elfie.
It was just a little bit too close to the high bar, but what was so important is that she didn't give away 1/10 to the judges. Now, she does this out of some full work at the top, very quick twist, stands it up nicely.
9.950 for Shannon Miller. Oh, boy, and this is the Belarusian swan, Svetlana Boginskaya. She's won 4 Olympic medals, 6 world championship medals, 8 European championship medals.
Of course, all she has to focus in on is that landing. She knows that she'll get a better score as long as she sticks.
Yeah, and she answered. She answered back with a perfect landing and the body position in the air. It just doesn't get any better than this. There's the round off. Look at her legs are glued together. Beautiful laid out position. Looks for the floor. And of course, this is what the judges are seeing.
This is their view.
The blind approach to the horse. Very difficult vault. And there's her trademark. See the one foot in front of the other.
And her score from the 6 judges, a 9.950. We will be able to have standings for you for the teams after they finish this first rotation and fourth. And here's the other battle we were talking about, the all-around scores after one rotation. Carrie Strug is in third place, and Kim Zemeskal has moved up into fourth. If she gets into the top three, she advances to the all-around. If she stays there in fourth, she will not. Kim needs a 9.987 to move into third place. This is the event that she's the world champion on. This is the event that she fell on. Compulsories, let's watch.
Yes, you need that down.
That's Bella Caroli's voice you hear in the background. So far, no problems.
Just the dismount. If she sticks, she just might do it. And oh, she's the only one at this point who understands just how important that final move is. Double back. Perfect.
There it is. A 9.912.
possibly the most difficult beam routine in the competition.
You know, you don't see those little wobbles that often from Shane Miller.
We saw Dominique do three layouts in a row. Shannon also does it right here.
Oh. Again, great, but I remember her in the rehearsal on podium. She was having problems out here in the competition hall. Whoa, again, another big break. She was supposed to hold that handstand for at least 2 seconds.
Let's put this team competition in perspective for you. For the Americans in particular, the last time the U.S. women's team won a team medal, any medal, in a non-boycott Olympics was 1948, and it was a bronze.
John, she has a lot of big tricks in this routine, and this is a big dismount, especially the landing. She handled it fairly well, but again, took a step to the side.
A 9.90. The United States has now dropped to third place following their performance on the balance beam. Romania moved up into second. Unified team still up there in gold medal position. Svetlana Boginskaya on the beam. Take a look.
And John, this is definitely one routine you cannot miss. We talk about Svetlana being such an artist. This is where she really shines through on this apparatus. Great acrobatic skill, two consecutive layouts.
There has been some bad blood between Boginskaya and American Kim Zmeskal during the awards ceremony for the World Championships. Svetlana was booed when she refused to shake Kim's hand, but Zmeskal had done the same thing to her the day before during the vault ceremony, and you perhaps will see Boginskaya and Zmeskal go head to head in the individual all around. Crowd applauding the floor exercise routine as Svetlana wrapped up her beam routine here. Here's a dismount.
Watch here, she just nails this dismount.
Svetlana Boginskaya, that was her beam routine, not only one of the best gymnasts on the unified team.
And her dismount was spectacular. As Tim said, she just nails the landing. Big score for the unified team.
9.925 is what she got on balance beam. And listen to the whistles that the judges got. They were expecting, the crowd was, a higher score than that. Floor exercise music. Here is that routine. Thank you.
the European judges favored this type of work.
A 9.90 on floor exercise. Kim Temescal. She had the fall on beam. Needs a 9.912 to move into third place among the U.S. gymnasts. And what that means is if she can move into third place, she will advance. She will not carry Strug out and advance to the individual all around. Coming up, a 9.925, so Zemeskal, entering the last rotation, has moved into third place. Back here at the Palau San Jordan, if they ended this competition right now, Kim Zemeskal in third position would be going to the individual all-around competition. Who does Bella root for? Shannon Miller is next up.
Just that little bit of a slide on that landing. But she knows you can't give those tenths away like that.
Right now, Svetlana Boginskaya for exercise. Acquired a variety of nicknames during her career, including the Queen of Perfection and the Belarusian Swan, is also known as the Goddess of Gymnastics. Trying to see if she can stay in third position ahead of Carrie Strug, her teammate, needs a 9.936. She will advance to the all-around.
She hasn't had much of a problem on this apparatus. We've seen her score two tens as recently as the Olympic trials in Baltimore.
Judges are scoring her first ball. She takes the... Oh, look at this, a 9.937, one one-thousandth of a point ahead of what she needed. So she is assured, the crowd is booing because they wanted a higher score, but she is insured at third position. She doesn't know it.
Oh, and better ball, much better ball.
A 9.950, so indeed higher than the first ball.